Many years ago, I made a documentary visiting all the Philadelphia locations from the Rocky films. So we've been there, done that. But what about Rocky IV? In that movie, he climbs a mountain.
Well, I've been wanting to do this for a long time, and I'm finally making the trip. I'm gonna find that mountain.
The movie takes place in Russia, so that's where I'm heading. Realized the mission had begun. For my crew, I brought Derek Wayne Johnson, who's directed a number of Rocky-related documentaries. Derek also edited a documentary about the making of the documentary about the Rocky IV director's cut.
It's cool. I told Sly that we were going to do this. So when you approached me about it, I told him he's very aware of what we're doing.
You're telling me that Sylvester Stallone knows that we're doing this.
Yes.
The locations of Rocky IV are very cryptic. There's some info on the old internet. Remember the cabin? Where was that? Remember the
Christmas movie?
To the west, you can see the Grand Teton mountain range, the same mountains you see in the film.
Yeah, we'll just accept it, is what Siberia looks like.
Yeah.
So, hey, why not?
We'll crack out here.
Yeah, like, hey, why don't I just leave my wife and kid? I've never thought of that.
We also saw plenty of prairie dogs. Classic. Well, the angle of the mountains is not exact because in the film, there's another peak that's sticking out. To get this precise angle, you'd have to go north a bit. So we followed the path until we saw this.
The sign here is telling us that if we go past this point, we're trespassing. So we can say confidently that we're trespassing. I like that scene where he's running by and he helps somebody out who's got a horse stuck in the snow. It's always cool. So we're kind of moving closer to the area where we suspect the cabin might have been.
It's supposed to be in Mormon Row, but there's one problem. There's a hill in the way. We unfortunately couldn't get too close to the hill because the area is home to private residences. So I climbed up to try to get a view, but there wasn't much to see.
So this is as close as I can possibly get.
So the Rocky cabin may have to stay a mystery.
We weren't quick enough to capture it on video, but a coyote just ran across the street. Boy, the stare that thing gave me. I'm glad we weren't out of the car when we saw that thing.
There's a scene where the guy watches Rocky cross the river. We wanted to find that bridge. If you face south, the position of the hill matches.
So he's standing in front of this probably, because if you count the screenshot, 1, 2, 3, and then a thick one.
That was pretty lucky.
This is where we'd make our ascent up the mountain.
Now in the movie, it seems Rocky just runs from the base all the way up the mountain, running all the way up there, knee deep, but not us. We're gonna take the lazy way.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Yeah. No, it's whoa. Yeah, there's no question about it. It's a perfect match. It's dead on.
We've confirmed, without a doubt, Sylvester Stallone was right over there.
So I think the spot where he was standing was somewhere past these ropes, which we can't get to, unfortunately, because there's some construction going on. It's not safe.
This is about as close as I could replicate the shot. Felt weird. There's even a Waffle House right near the spot.
They just like pouring syrup on waffles.
You can count on Rocky to make it up a big, scary Waffle House.
Us? Well, it's quite a hike. Well.
Yeah, I don't know. We're here.
You want to do it? You want to
say we do it?
Yeah.
Rocky could do it. We can do it.
Well, we'll see.
As the ominous mountain got closer, a feeling of dread came over us.
This is crazy.
The video does not do it justice. Seeing it in person is the only way to know how risky it is. I had underestimated it. It looks so easy. Hey, I can do that. There's more to it. For one thing, we could have used some proper climbing gear. It seemed like a good idea to wear my old beat up shoes because, hey, they get beaten up anyway, but the treads were all worn down and I kept slipping.
And with this wind going on?
What's up?
The wind.
You see, I couldn't even hear you.
If we get hurt here, it's not an option. There's just nothing, like, what are we gonna do?
Earlier, a kid actually fell about 50 feet or so.
Yeah.
We didn't witness it, but we were there right after it happened. And well, what are we gonna do?
So we went on an excursion looking for a less risky route or any other way to get up that damn mountain. Down by Cody Bowl is when we realized how high it actually was. I tried to fly a drone up there and still wasn't able to get close to the peak. But the risks were weighing on us, and I think we reached our limit.
You know, there were a group of hikers, they were teenagers, and they went up a little bit further than us.
A lot was going on inside my head right there.
Jesus Christ. Fuck! There goes the onion.
For decades, I have pushed myself as hard as I could to make videos, wanting to always deliver the best product for the fans. But how far would I be willing to push myself? I just kept looking up there thinking, we had already slipped countless times. Slip here, I fall on my ass, no big deal. I imagine those red X's like in Zelda Breath of the Wild that mark each spot where you died. My thoughts were very complicated that moment, but the biggest overriding thought was my children, how I had a responsibility to come back home.
You know, before I went on this trip, I the night before I left, I was putting my youngest daughter to bed, and she was, you know, like, kind of sad, you know, like, I'm gonna miss you, Daddy, like, and I'm like, you know, don't worry, I'm gonna be back in just a few days, it's not gonna be that long, and, so I'm letting her know, you know, are you scared? You know, if a big giant, you know, wanted to fight me, I'd be scared, you know. Yeah.
As Derek and I turned back, I wondered, what was the true meaning of this trip?
Jesus Christ.
So, we didn't reach that last location, but it ain't over yet. I may not be as skilled at mountain climbing, but I guess I am skilled at
watching stuff on YouTube.
So there's this amazing, highly professional drone footage you can see on Vimeo, posted many years ago by photographer Tristan Gresko. It shows two skiers making the impressive climb up Mount Cody. But if you pause the video here and compare the rocks, wouldn't you say this is a perfect match? So we cracked the case.
We'll crack out here.
But we're not going to end without leaving a little mystery behind, because there exists a wooden crate, which you can see more clearly thanks to this video posted on YouTube.
Oh my God, like mystery boxes are everywhere.
What is the purpose of this crate?
Why is it in the exact spot where
Rocky
stood?
Could it be something left behind by production?
What could possibly be inside?
What are stories but mystery boxes? There's a fundamental question.
So even though we didn't make it all the way up that mountain.
Cheers, we did it.
Yeah.
What's up with that one guy that's always following Rocky around?